Hey everyone, this is Eran from Stern FX, and today I want to talk to you about Mosaic, which is a stylization plugin that allows you to create adaptive tiling, pixel texturing, and ASCII effects. This tool supports Final Cut Pro 10, Motion After Effects, and Premiere Pro on the macOS platform only. Now, the way that this tool works is by splitting your footage into a set of tiles. And then each tile is mapped with an image fragment, and the result is that you have control on the color, contrast, details, and distribution of the original image that is assembled from this pattern or by a custom pattern that you define. Now I'm going to demonstrate Mosaic using Adobe After Effects, because here in this software you have the maximum control on its tools. So I'll start by showing you the basic workflow, and then I'm going to take you through a few examples that goes deeper and integrate some third-party tools which are only available inside After Effects. So we're going to start with this video of Michal, one of my daughters, which is standing in front of the New Tate Gallery in London. And if you're going to search for the name Mosaic, at least inside After Effects in the Effects and Preset panel, you will come up with two effects. So I'm going to select this layer and apply the built-in mosaic effect. Let's just raise the horizontal and vertical blocks to say 50, and also enable sharp colors, just so you can get a sense of what this effect, the built-in effect, is doing, which is a great effect if you need to do some modification to a face, meaning you want to hide it or just create a simple digital look. But the Yanobox version of Mosaic is much more advanced. So I'm going to delete this, and instead I'm going to apply the new Mosaic effect. And I'm just going to start from the beginning and press spacebar in order to generate a preview. And immediately you can see that the result is completely different. So this is the default state. You can see that the effect is extracting a key and generating tiles based on the image itself. Now, obviously you can animate it over time. So for example, under the extraction option, under the threshold, we can start from zero, create a keyframe, and then let's say across 2 seconds, bring it all the way back to its maximum of one. And you can see how the image is filling itself with this digital look. But I think that if you want to create it, you may want to separate the foreground from the background. And this is exactly what I did over here. So I've used After Effects built-in masking and tracking tools in order to actually mask away just the portion of the image which I want to keep in focus. And then I can apply the effect even without keyframes, and it will actually look more interesting. Now, of course, you can keep the animation, or you can choose from different presets, and some of them are going to really surprise you. So let me just show you a few of the possibilities. So I'm going to select for beginning the circles and crosses. And once again, I'm going to create a RAM preview. In this case, we have a black and white version. So I've already applied levels and tint. Let me just enable them to the footage just so it will integrate better. So this is one way that you can use this effect. Let's choose another preset just so you'll get a sense of what you have built in this effect. So the crop type, for example, is very interesting. And let's just look for a different one. I also like the crossword overlay, which looks very interesting. Once again, especially if you're animating the threshold over time, so you can get a sense of how this is going to look even without the animation. Now let's also visit maybe the Luma Values Adaptive, which I highly recommend for you to check as well. This is a very nice one. And once again, you can play with those presets until you find something that fits the narrative of your video. So in this case, let's go with maybe the technical color. And as before, I'm going to animate quickly the threshold, so the effect will expand over time. And as you can see, this is working almost in real time, so the render times are very, very quick. Now, if you want more graphic representations of these presets, go ahead to yanobox.com, and over there, click on the Mosaic effect, scroll down the page, and you will see a thumbnail sample of each one of those presets so you can get a sense of what they will do when you are going to apply them. So back to After Effects, let's look at few other examples. In this case, I'm starting with the footage, and then I've applied the 3D camera tracker here inside After Effects. This will create lots of trackers, so you can place this target on the floor, click on it, and then right click and create a solid. This will place this solid over here, and then on top of this solid, you can actually place a lot of effects, and this is exactly what I did. So I'm just going to say goodbye to this track solid, and I'm going to enable one of those effects. Let me just clear the mosaic and the CC Repetal FX icon, so you'll get a sense of how I've built this. In this case, I'm using the fractal noise in order to generate some sort of a noise pattern. And from this noise pattern, I will create the mosaic effect. I'm animating it using the evolution. So there is a simple expression here, which is time times 500. This is going to cycle the animation. And then I'm going to apply the mosaic effect. And once again, I'm using a preset, this time the ASCII symmetric. So this is how it is going to appear in this case. And if you want to stretch it through the whole corridor over here, or the imaginary corridor, I should say, you can use the CC Repetal effect, which will expand it down, up, right and left, depending on your need, and will result with this effect. And using the same recipe, I've created a few more. So here is the pixel gradient preset. And once again, the principle is the same. I'm choosing a preset, applying it to this layer after the fractal noise is generating the pattern. And in this case, I'm just selecting different material colors which are part of this preset. This is how this is going to look. Super, super useful and very, very beautiful, at least to my eyes. And once again, another variation. This time I'm using the wire and circles. And in order to animate it across the screen, I'm using linear wipe. I'm actually using two instances of it. The first one is just to create the fade at the beginning, and the second one is to actually create the wipe itself, which reveals the texture, the mosaic texture, I should say, across the screen. So those are all simple examples, but let's say that you want to create something unique, something custom, maybe some sort of a futuristic user interface, or fantasy user interface, or fictional user interface, whatever you want, maybe even a fake user interface. They are all going with the same three letters, FUI. So in this case, let me just show you one example. And by the way, this example is a breakdown of a scene that was created by Jean-Marc Noël, which is the maker of this tool, also known as Yanobox, of course. And that's right, this is the same guy who brought you the wonderful Nodes 2 effect, just if you are curious. Anyhow, let's see how Jean-Marc built this. So first we are starting with this mosaic user interface, but in this case, instead of using one of the presets over here, we're actually feeding it with a custom texture. So this texture is layer number 7. I'm just going to double click in order to open it up in its new window. So this is a separate comp. And this is just a simple Illustrator design. So of course, simple is a relative term, but in this case, it is not too complicated. And on top of it, there are a few bars which create some sort of a very, very simple animation. So some of those elements are just hiding from us or maybe turning on and off, some sort of a movement. And of course, you can create some blinking stuff, etc. You get the drift. But using this grid, using these tiles, you can feed it back to the mosaic plugin, and this will create this sophisticated mosaic effect. Now, obviously, we can see that things are turning on and off here, and this is because the mosaic layer is also consisting of several masks. So if I'm just going to enable those masks are actually telling the effects where we want it to be visible and where not. So in this case, this is how it looks. Now, if you combine it with another copy, and in this case, we are just using one of the presets which create nice crosshairs, but the masks are the same just in order to create this nice variation, then you can create this very sophisticated user interface, which goes on and off and all is based on the same illustrator design, once again using this effect. And if you want to take it a step further, well, you can add a camera, because this effect is 3D aware, as you can see by this small cube over here in the effect controls. And then if you want to take it even further, well, you can apply some depth of field. Now, in this case, this effect doesn't support depth of field. It does support motion blur, just in case you need it. But we are faking the depth of field using this shape layer, and we are feeding it to an adjustment layer using the camera lens blur effect. So if I'm going to open up the blur map, you can see that this DOF, depth of field ramp, is actually using the values from what I've just shown you, this shape layer. On top of it, we have some color balance effects. So this is before and this is after, just to bring in some bluish tint over here. And if I'm going to run preview the result, this is how it looks. Very exciting. And if you want to ingest even more excitement, well, you can just take the camera and create a few different angles from the same comp as I'm showing it over here. And then, of course, use After Effects or Premiere Pro multi-camera options in order to cut between them, just so it will look more interesting. Once again, depending on your needs. Now, before I'm going to show you the last example, which is integrating Mosaic with Element 3D, I'm just going to mention that this clip took much more time to create. So it's actually in reality took around 30 minutes. So here is a condensed clip, fast forward, condensing 30 minutes to 2 minutes of all the stages and all the process that Jean-Marc Knoll created in order to generate this effect. Pretty amazing, right? And this is not the end. Of course, you can integrate more tools into this mix. So for example, if I'm going to show you this comp, and I've already queued a RAM preview, so I'm just going to press spacebar so you can get a sense of what we have here. This is a 3D torus, and the camera is actually moving inside of it. This model was created in Cinema 4D and then exported and imported into Element 3D, and all the depth of field that you are seeing here, including the mosaic texture, is part of this effect. So the texture itself consists basically from the same steps that I showed you before, so a custom illustrator map, that was created inside After Effects. Just know that this composition is quite large. It is 8K, so the pixels are needed in order to get a better quality. So this layer is over here in the timeline. The eye is turned off, obviously. And here in this solid layer, I've applied the element effect. And under custom layers, it is very important to define this layer as a custom texture. So this is what we are seeing over here. Now, if I'm going to click on the scene setup, we can get a sense of how Element is going to treat this. And over here, we can get a sense of what we are looking at. So once again, a huge torus that we are actually looking through and moving the camera along those lines. Now, in order to define a different material, all you need to do is just select the material itself, which is the default one, usually a gray material. Then come down to the textures inside Element 3D. And in this case, we are using the illumination, but you can, of course, try different passes. So just click on it when it says non-set and choose from your custom layers. And here, if you need to, you can change the UV repeat as long as other stuff until you get the look that you're after. After that, just click OK, place your camera, create some interesting animation, and don't forget to turn on depth of field over here if you want to create this sense of definition. And this is, of course, all thanks to the built-in capabilities of the rendering inside Element 3D. Once again, you can create different angles. So in this case, if I'm just going to run preview the other comp, here we are seeing the camera is taking just a different path across the same scene. So once again, same principles applied. I'm just going to return to this guy because I think it is just super exciting. And the way to create it is much more simpler than you may think at the beginning. So here are a few ideas of how you may want to use the mosaic effect. If you want to learn more, go to fxfactory.com and download a free trial. Until next time, this is Eran from SternFX. Thank you very much and have a great day. Bye-bye.